No, bueno, sí, Francisella tularensis, this bacteria is a gram negative, extremely small bacteria, so it is a Coccobacillus, gram negative, and is a facultative intracellular bacteria that lives inside the phagosome of the macrophage. So first we have the macrophage phagocytize the Francisella, so here it is. Here inside the phagosome, also Francisella inhibits the diffusion of lysosome and phagosome. It could be inhibiting diffusion or other mechanisms in which the Francisella is not destroyed by the phagolysosome. So it's intracellular, facultative intracellular, but lives inside the macrophage, and then the macrophage of the reticuloendothelial system spreads the bacteria to the blood, and it is a granulomatous response because we cannot destroy the bacteria, so just the macrophage maintain the wall of the bacteria, but we cannot destroy it. Alright, we have four kinds of tularemia, that is the disease caused by Francisella tularensis. We have the ulceroglandular tularemia, pneumonic tularemia, oculoglandular, and typhoidal. Alright, in the ulceroglandular, that is the most common, here we have formation of kind of like bubbles, like in pneumonic plague and the bubonic plague in Yersinia. But we also have the ulceration at the site of the first infection, at the site of the entry of the bacteria. We have also the ulceration of the skin, as opposed to Yersinia. And then infects into the macrophage in the reticuloendothelial system and goes to the blood. This could be transmitted by the thick, the mercator. Also the thick responsible for rickettsia rickettsii, or in contact with rabbits, with blood of the rabbits. Also we have transmission is through the mercator thick or flies of deers, or contact with rodents, could be rabbits or other rodents. Alright, next is the pneumonic. This is with contact of the aerosolized bacteria. Could be, for example, while the hunter is skinning the rabbit, if the hunter inhales the bacteria, there could have the pneumonic type of the disease. Next, the oculoglandular. This is the one that is associated with damage to the eyes and cervical lymphadenopathy. And the typhoidal is for ingestion of meat contaminated or water contaminated, and present with GI symptoms, GI tract symptoms, and systemic symptoms. The treatment for tularemia is streptomycin, and we sometimes do add other drugs, but let's stay with streptomycin. Could also be streptomycin or gentamicin, both aminoglucosides. The diagnosis is difficult because it is intracellular bacteria, but it grows in buffer charcoal yeast extract, the same as Legionella, and we could see it with the direct fluorescent antibody testing.